What's going on, guys? Sam bringing your new alumni team, the University of Minnesota Golden Gophers. As you can see here, they're actually 86 overall. I think they're the second lowest rated alumni team. Only the Erie Otters are actually lower rated. But honestly, I think playoffs, maybe, definitely not going to be finishing first or anything. Hopefully don't finish last. You guys will see. It's kind of a weird structure to the team. Some parts of it are really good. Other parts aren't so great. So I'll start off here showing you the logo. Obviously, kind of similar to Michigan, they have the M. Now, couldn't find an M like their actual logo. I thought this one here was the closest to it. Thought about maybe using the modern M, which is what I used for Michigan, but wanted to mix it up. So I feel like that's not too bad considering what we had to work with. It's either that or like the college ones, which are like really skinny and just don't look that good in my opinion. Obviously, team colors there, you got burgundy and gold for the Minnesota Golden Gophers. So team uniforms here, I'll show you guys the home and away jersey. These two, I felt like I did the best I could, but both the home and away jersey are like really unique in certain aspects, and I just couldn't make them happen in games. So basically just had to work with what we had. Right there though is the home jersey. I feel like it turned out pretty good, honestly. Obviously we got the white and yellow stripes on the shoulders. Now the bottom stripes, it's supposed to be white on top, yellow on the bottom. Unfortunately though, they coincide with the top stripes, so no way I can make that work. Also the sleeves there are a little bit off, but other than that, I think it's pretty solid. Like the numbers, helmet, pants, socks, that all looks pretty good. And then looking at the away jersey here, this one obviously did my best too. So we have that yellow stripe across the shoulders. Unfortunately, those sleeves definitely aren't accurate. You can see there we have two yellow stripes as they go along with the yellow stripe on the shoulders. So there's no way to make it one yellow stripe. But honestly, I don't think it looks too bad. The socks are also a little bit off. Their socks are really weird. It's like one burgundy piece and then a small yellow one that's like near the top. There's no sock like that in game. It's a very weird sock and not very many teams have it. Now, even though the jerseys aren't 100% accurate, I still feel like they look pretty good in game. I'll give you guys one final look at the home and away. So right there was the home skater and goalie. And right here, one final look at the away skater and goalie again. I feel like the colors look pretty good. Definitely, there's no team, I don't think, with burgundy and gold in the NHL. So definitely cool to like mix it up that way. Details here, obviously, Golden Gophers. I think they go by Gophers mostly, though. Play-by-play team name there, Golden Hams. Unfortunately, no Gophers are in-game, so Golden Hams is half the team name. Figured we'd use that. Arena name there is the 3M Arena. Again, most of that stuff doesn't really matter since we're not doing the owner mode. But now we'll get to the franchise, and I'll show you guys what this roster is actually looking like. Now, for the franchise sim, guys, I'm going to be taking out the Dallas Stars, as they're the lowest-rated team in the Central, and obviously the University of Minnesota has to be playing in the Central. Thought about taking out Minnesota Wild, but I think it might be more fun to leave them in and see which of us does better. I'm pretty sure the Wild are going to do better than us, seeing as they're much higher-rated, but you never know. So I'll sub in this team here. You guys can see the top players before I show you the entire roster. I actually don't think there's a single Minnesota Wild player on this team. As you can see there, top players, Phil Kessel, Blake Wheeler, and Brady Shea. So Kessel, Wheeler are definitely going to have to carry. Also, guys, with this team being 86 overall, we're not only the lowest rated team in the Central, but also the NHL. Vancouver and Ottawa are the next closest, both at 87. So again, kind of like with some other teams, I'm just hoping we don't get last. And if we somehow make the playoffs, that'd be even better. And now, guys, I'm going to show you the roster. As you can see there, team status is Rebuilder, obviously. I mean, we're only 86 overall rated, but I feel like we have a chance. That's all we need. Maybe somehow this team can make the playoffs. So first line here is pretty solid. Blake Wheeler, Eric Halla, Phil Kessel. Obviously, like I said earlier, relying heavily on Kessel. I believe they're the only two first line forwards on this team. I mean, they're both sick, though. If you look at their stats, awesome hands, awesome shot. Again, hopefully they can both have, like, you know, 100-point seasons, maybe. We definitely need that from them if we want any shot of the playoffs. Second line is also pretty solid. Okposo, Bukestad, and Vanek. Third line is definitely where it gets worse. So you have Travis Boyd. Casey Middlestat, though, is pretty solid. He's got that elite potential, so maybe he can even grow during the season. And Letary there. Now, both Letary and Boyd are normally centers. I switched them over to the wing. Same goes for Raw and Schrader on the fourth line. I hope his name's Raw. I don't know how else you'd say that. O'Brien there is the center. So obviously, you can rely heavily on this top six. Hopefully they can get it done for us. Now moving on to the defense, it's pretty solid. No like number one defenseman, but we do have a lot of depth. So top pair there you can see is Brady Shea and Eric Johnson. Second pair there is Schmidt and Letty. And then third pair is Goligoski and Mike Riley. So kind of similar to like Vegas where we don't really have a number one, but we do have a lot of depth. I would say five of these six guys are top four D-men. And then the other one in Mike Riley is like a top six, probably a bottom pair guy. And then Shea, of course, too, has that elite potential. So if he has a good season, he could actually be a number one D-man for us. If he ends up being like 87 or something during the course of the year. Now, goaltending is definitely the roughest spot for this team. As you can see here, we have 269s. Unfortunately, that's not too nice for a franchise sim. Adam Wilcox here, he's actually the only goalie I could find that played for the University of Minnesota. 25 years old, potential their AHL starter. Drafted by the Lightning, he's currently in the Buffalo system playing for Rochester. So 69 for a starter is not too good. Miska here, he actually played for the University of Minnesota Duluth, from Minnesota as well, and he's the same rating, so I figured he'd be good for the backup, as when he has to play, same rating as Wilcox, so it'd be as if Wilcox was starting for us. Now, having 269 goalies isn't really ideal, but I have seen Edmonton make the playoffs before with 275s, and I don't know if our team's better than Edmonton. I mean, our defense definitely is, so maybe it's possible. It's gonna be tough, but let's see what happens. Also, guys, before I start the sim, a few more things I wanted to show you. The first here is the captaincy. So as you can see there, Blake Wheeler is the captain. He'll be rocking the C. And then Kessel and Johnson are the two alternates. Like I mentioned earlier, we really need a big year from Kessel here. I mean, Cheeseburger Phil usually comes through in these sims. Now, he is playing with, like, Crosby on the Penguins, but he's won the Art Ross a bunch of times in all these sims I've done. Also want to show you guys how we did in the preseason. I thought it was kind of funny. So we actually started out really strong. We went 4-0-1 in the first five games, didn't lose in regulation, and then last game here, 9-0 loss to the St. Louis Blues. So really hope that's not showing us what's to come in the regular season. Also want to show you guys our offense, defense, and goaltending ratings. So as you guys can see here, we have 89 offense, only two below Arizona, 92 defense for the exact same rating. It's really just our goaltending, 71. That's going to be so much lower than everyone else's. So it is going to be interesting to see how much that hinders us. Also right there, you can see Phil Kessel rocking the Minnesota jersey. I think he looks good there. Showed you guys Wheeler rocking the C earlier. Honestly, I'm liking the jerseys the more and more I look at them. So now for real, we're going to get started with the sim here. And just hoping we don't finish last. All right, guys, so this is kind of nuts. We're at the trade deadline now with a record of 24, 26, and 12. Obviously, we have a negative record, but I thought we'd be doing a lot worse than this. Also, too, we have 12 OT losses, so clearly we're in like a bunch of tight games. We're actually like 11 and 11 through the first couple months, and I thought no way that was gonna last. I think we actually lost like five straight after that, but then rallied back a bit. So curious to see if we actually have still a shot at the playoffs. Like, if we even have a shot, that's impressive. We are last in the division, but 14 points out there, Colorado's wildcard spot. Let's see, 13 points from the Coyotes, so I guess you could say we have a shot. It definitely is a long shot. Honestly, though, I didn't think we'd be anywhere close to 500. Phil Kessel there, he is doing great, basically averaging a point per game. That's very impressive. Also, too, as I was simming, totally forgot to show you guys that we actually have a couple more players on this team that are scratched. So the first one here, Hudson Fashing. I believe he actually had a really good college career, unfortunately. Hasn't really translated that to the NHL. And the next one here, Justin Kluse. Not too familiar with him. I probably messed his name up. Both 70s though, so they're just shy of like making our fourth line forwards. But aside from that, guys, we'll get back to the sim. Obviously, probably not gonna make the playoffs, but the fact that there's even any semblance of a chance is pretty awesome. All right, guys, if we win these last two games, we actually will finish 500. And look at that. No way. We actually, I think, won our last four games straight. And honestly, I'm pretty happy as I was doing the sim, I was just hoping we'd finish 500. And with four games remaining, we were four games below 500 and somehow won the last four straight. We actually only let in four goals in those four games. Got a shutout win there against the Minnesota Wild in our final game. So even though it looks like they're onto the playoffs and we aren't, the fact that we beat them in the final game of the season 4-0, that's kind of like our Stanley Cup there, beating the Wild 4-0. That's pretty awesome. Final record there as well, 34, 34, and 14. I have a feeling like you might have the most overtime losses of any team in the league. So, I don't know, that's kind of cool. That was a fun sim, even though we did not make the playoffs. 82 points. So, yeah, we averaged a point per game. Basically, yeah, we got like an overtime loss every game. Makes sense. Phil Kessel there, he went off 90 points in 82 games. Maybe we have the Art Ross Trophy winner. That'd be pretty awesome. There is a chance that it's Phil Kessel and the Penguins. Let's see how the entire team did. I'm obviously very happy. Like I mentioned before, this team's 86 overall, so that's one below the Michigan alumni team, and they finished last in the league. So the fact that this team was like middle of the pack is pretty awesome, I think. Again, Kessel there, 90 points, 82 games, just unreal. Wheeler there, 84, so both of them went off. I thought maybe one of them would be a 90 now, not the case. Halla there, 59. That's pretty good for him too. Vanek Okposo, middle south 40, still a 79. I thought maybe he'd be at least an 80. Bjugstad almost 40. Shea, he is up 1 to 85. So, I mean, it looks like, you know, everyone was pitching in a good amount. Even the defensemen there look like they all have 20 plus points except for Riley, who had 12, which isn't really that bad either. So goalies here, I'm curious to see this. Wilcox here got the majority of the starts by a little bit. 16, 23, and 9.912, 2.7. Miska here, though, had even better stats. Like I mentioned, he actually played for Minnesota Duluth, who's basically like a sister school. 18 and 12 there, 0.922 and 2.47. So that's kind of crazy. Both still 69s, though. We'll take a look here, too, and see who finished first the entire league in scoring. Look at this, guys. Patrick Laine had 97 points, almost had 50 and 50, was 3 goals shy. That'd be pretty sick. Kessel there on the Penguins was second, so I was right. I mean, he's playing with Crosby, he's gonna put up more points. The fact that, I mean, ours put up 90 with only 4 shy is pretty impressive. Malkin as well, 91. I wonder if they ran all 3 of those guys on the first line and they just kind of carried the team, because that looks like it kind of what happened. Blake Wheeler there on the Jets also outscored our Blake Wheeler by 2 points. Obviously, him, Scheifele, and Laine was the Winnipeg Jets top line. So, I mean, that's pretty sick. I'm surprised. Kessel and Wheeler definitely, you know, carried our team. So let's check down and see where we finished the entire NHL. I honestly don't think we were too bad. If we're like even 19 plus, like in the teens, I'd be very happy with that. So in terms of wildcard spot, we were shy by 11 points, which obviously is a good bit of games, but nothing crazy. San Jose there won the President's Trophy with 115 points. That's kind of nuts. Like I said, Minnesota Wild obviously made the playoffs, finished 8th there. Let's see, are we in the teens? We are not in the teens. Let's see. Wow, Montreal makes it ranked 20th. We finished 24th, though, so I mean, that's pretty respectable, I think. Like, we're not too close to the bottom, so I feel like we still have our pride. And 14 overtime losses was actually not the most. Looks like Arizona there had 15. That's kind of ridiculous. And who finished last in the entire league? The New York Islanders there, 64 points. I mean, we did do better than, what, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 teams? I feel like we'll take that. It's not too bad. We'll send through the rest of the season, though, see if we did get maybe any awards. Kessel, Wheeler, possibly with, like, an MVP. Who knows? And we're now at the end of the season here, guys. As you can see there, Detroit Red Wings picking first overall. I would love for that to happen. Get Jack Hughes. Him and Dylan Larkin, I feel, just tear the NHL up. We have the 9th pick there. Luckily, we're not continuing on. It's not too big of a deal. Again, I'm just happy we were like a competitive team. A lot of these alumni teams just get absolutely destroyed. So that's just nice to see, you know, we're in games. Keep them close. Tampa Bay Lightning there are your Stanley Cup champions. Really no surprise. I honestly feel like they win half the time in these first year sims. Like, that team is just so stacked. They really should win it all this year. And take a look at the playoff tree now. Tampa Bay beat the Winnipeg Jets there in a best of 5. Honestly, I feel like there's a very good chance that could be the Stanley Cup final this year. Lightning there beating the Maple Leafs best of 7 first round, Bruins best of 6. And then they took out both Columbus and Winnipeg in 5. So looking at the awards now, obviously we already know all the team awards. Player awards here, Art Ross goes to Laine. Maybe Kessel somehow gets the heart. Laine gets the heart. I feel like if the game actually looked at our team, Kessel definitely has a case, him or Wheeler at least. James Norris goes to Letang. Kessel on the Penguins gets Lady Bing, come on. Calder goes to Peterson. Vasilevskiy there with the Conn Smythe. Dubnyk gets the Vezina, that's kind of cool. Also gets the William M. Jennings. So Minnesota Wild, you know, they saw the other Minnesota team entering the NHL, made sure to play well this year. Edmondson there with the Bill Masterson, O'Reilly with the Selke, Laine also got the Ted Lindsay, and then Ovechkin there with the Maurice Richard. So unfortunately, no player awards. Like I was saying, I'm still pretty happy with how this team played. Kessel putting up 90 points is also pretty unreal. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this alumni team video. If you did, leave that thumbs up. Also guys, we just hit 99,000 subscribers yesterday. I am so pumped. We only have 1,000 more to go before we hit the big 100k, so cannot wait for that. If you guys have not subscribed yet, please do that. Help me hit the milestone. I really want to get that silver play button. But that is it, guys, for this video. As always, thank you for watching. Have a nice day, guys. Goodbye.